What's up, guys? Happy Friday. I've been taking my diet very, very serious. As you can see, I'm eating Greek yogurt with blueberries. Yeah, not as good as some tacos al pastor or una torta de milanesa with extra aguacate. Not close, but it is what it is. What's up, guys? All right, today I have a scary cartel story, and it's called The Mexican Freddy Krueger. Let's get into this video. Drugs, money, mansions, and private jets. A myth is being created around the narco culture. Narco culture has gone mainstream and can be seen in various areas like music, religion, soap operas, fashion, and language. But it's not all the pretty roses people like to see. Join me as I tell you the truth behind cartel life. This is narco culture. What's up, guys? My name is JC. I am Wrong and Strong. If you're new to my channel, make sure you subscribe, hit that bell so you don't miss nothing. If you're part of my crew, mi familia, mi raza, you already know. Súbanse a la Suburban. Let's get this fucking video on the road. What's up, guys? Great news. I got a message today that a group is going to be working on the Suburban song, theme song. So it's going to be out for you to be able to download it, everything, but that is in the workings right now. As you guys know, the Suburban shirt is for sale, and it's in the YouTube Teespring link down below. I'll leave it. Hey, support the cause. Support the Suburban. What's up, guys? Today I have a scary, I wouldn't say scary, but it's a little fucked up story about the cartel. There was a family that was bringing in a lot of work in Chicago, a lot of work. And they owned a bunch of body shops all over Chicago. And at night, what they would do is unload the cars. Because when you're bringing in merch from Mexico, you use every mean possible. You don't just stick to one. You send cars, you send trucks, you send planes. You whatever you can to get as much as you can here. At the end of the day, the game is to get as much work as you can. Well, they were unloading. And one night at an auto body shop, I'm gonna leave names out and the families because it's just, it is what it is. One of the tanks was not properly unloaded from the gas and everything, and car exploded, causing the person that was unloading it to completely get burned all over his body. Third degree burns all over his body. Well, the family was afraid to take him to the hospital because they thought that maybe he would say something. So what happened is they put him in a car and they drove his ass all the way to Mexico from Chicago in that car. So just imagine the pain, the suffering, and everything he was going through in that ride all the way to Mexico. So they took him to Mexico to go see the doctor down there. I don't know. That's pretty harsh and pretty fucked up. So once he got to Mexico, they, you know, worked on him and everything. But he was completely burnt. He looked like Freddy Krueger. I mean, his ears, everything was burnt. And when he came back to the United States, they were still, you know, making him work. Still, you know, doing a lot of unloads, loads, dropping off. He ended up actually getting caught and actually testifying against the twins and that big case that started right before they snatched up the twins. But he actually was cooperating. He's actually doing some prison time now. My message on this whole video is there's a lot of people that are used in the dope game. I hate to say it like that, but it's the truth. There's a lot of people that don't ever excel or get beyond just being a peon, just being a person that unloads the car, just being a person that drops the merch, becoming a person that just indispensable. There's a lot of people like that. It's because it's a dog eat dog world. There's people that make it to the top really fast, like the twins. You know, there's people that stay at the bottom their whole life, and you know, they're called bottom feeders. You know, they wait for the scraps to fall or jobs to be, you know, called for, and they do them. But at the end of the day, whether you're on top or on the bottom, you always either end up in prison or in jail. Someone is going to testify against you or someone is gonna try and kill you. They say that there is, you know, Cinderella stories. Well, that's the thing. That's what it is. It's a Cinderella story. There's not too many people that actually made it out the game and was able to keep all their money and keep everything. It just doesn't happen like that. This person ended up completely disformed, burnt, everything, and he was still, you know, what do you want me to do? Where should I go? And at the end, I guess that was one of the biggest reasons why he testified against them, was because he felt used and never made it to the top. Well, if you let people use you, guess what? They'll use you. This is why it's so important for you to love yourself and change yourself and stand by yourself, because at the end of the day, people don't care. People care about themselves, me. They don't care about you. So this is why Wrong the Strong is so important, because I didn't start to change my life until I actually started to value myself and know that I could stand alone, that I didn't need a gang, that I didn't need money, that I didn't need a lot of things that I used to think that I needed to survive. What I started to do was love myself, educate myself, and just start to surround myself with a lot of different people now that are good people that I look up to, and some of them mentor me and I want to become like them. You know, there's a saying that says, tell me who you hang around with and I'll tell you who you are. That's how it is in life. You have to surround yourself with some people that you want to be like, that you admire, that you set yourself goals to do, and it is what it is. That's just life. Right now, my biggest thing that I want to do is, you know, drop this weight, lean out, take my acting classes. I just signed up for a year of acting classes. I'm gonna be coming back and forth from LA. We might be moving to Florida in the next year. So building my fitness app to go completely online for, you know, the training and everything, and just creating a different world and different environment for myself, because that's what I want and that's what I believe in. We'll be releasing at least 2 of my books this year. So all this stuff is started off with loving myself. Don't be nobody's bottom feeder. Don't be nobody's peon. Don't be nobody's bitch. Create your own destiny. Write your own book. Remember, you can go from wrong to strong. Hey, if I did it, you could do it. My name's JC. I am Wrong to Strong. Hey, don't judge nobody. Stay in your lane. Live savage. And remember, you only have one life to live, bro. Might live it out here, free, sober, without gangbanging, and just living life. I'll catch you guys on the rebound.